sailed the seas to China on a square clipper ship. And they signed him on as carpenter on the fast rig wooden boat. And every hand on board that ship knew he kept them all afloat. But old Harry Ware was a lively man, traveled far and wide. He had 12 children to his name, and he had 3 lovely brides. And he sailed across to China with a happy crew and good. The captain pushed them hard, they say, but no harder than he should. Old Harry Ware from beyond the sea, and my family from the distant past are watching over me. Well, on a flood tide ported to Shanghai with this lively waterfront. And they moored the ship beside the quay and went to shore for grub. Then they stocked the hold with precious tea while Harry grabbed his mate. And they plied their craft and patched her up till the ship was in good shape. And he dreamed of his dear Fanny Prudence, and he longed for her sweet scent. But the good folk that he left behind, and his home in County Kent. But a fight broke out in a Shanghai bar, they'd all had one too many. But a man pulled a knife on Harry Ware and stuck him in the belly. But old Harry didn't die, and he went below to nurse his aching side. The fast ship set sail and left the port on a fair wind ebbing tide. 2,000 tons, narrow on the beam, the rough ocean she withstood. With a full spread of canvas and a skysail set, she was the fastest ship of wood. Beyond the sea, and my family from the distant past are watching over me. When the trade winds blew and every hand rose to the call, 14,000 miles to go, 102 days in all. And there's no finer sight you'll ever see as a square rear clipper ship, hard on the wind and flying proud across a wind-torn wave spindrift. We're the South China Sea and the Indian Ocean, the Cape of Good Hope they saw. Across the Atlantic, storm-swept sea, to England's southern shore. The land ahoy, the crow's nest cried, and every hand rejoiced. Especially tough old Harry Ware, who'd almost lost his voice. Beyond the sea, and my family from the distant past are watching over me. Well, down the English Channel, they hold their sails past a Dungeness sand and rocks. And up the River Thames at last to the East India docks. Poor old Harry survived that grueling trip, his knife wound healed at last. And he opened up a carpenter's shop in Bromley, and he laughed about his past. Old Harry Ware, from beyond the sea, and my family from the distant past are watching over me. Where there is no moral to this tale, but to say he lived life well. Nobody makes it out alive to your heaven or your hell. Old Harry Ware, from beyond the sea, and my family from the distant past are reaching out to me. Old Harry Ware, from beyond the sea, and my family from the distant past are watching over me.